Welcome to Gosford. How are we all? Great to see you all. My name's Billy Bell. Now, there's lots of fans out here who walked down that road fabulously today who don't know each other. So before I speak, can we have an Irish welcome? Turn to the person on your left. Hey, calm down, you. Thank you. Turn to the person on your left. That's it, an Irish welcome. Smack him in the mouth.
Give us a sash.
Hold on, lads. One of my proudest days. Do you remember at Arsenal? Yes. Why? When? My missus uses this every Saturday night. Why do you come home pissed? When are you going to grow up? But enough of me. Ladies and gentlemen, we're very honoured today. Shh. The former players this year, we have been let down by everybody, by the club, the council, you name it, we've all been felt let down. It was the 50th anniversary of Jimmy Hill's team getting promotion from Division 3. And one of those players... Thanks, lad. One of those players is here today. He's come to speak to you. Put your hands together and welcome Mr. Ronnie Farmer. Ronnie, it's been a very, very sad year for the former players. What people don't realise is the camaraderie we had built up at the football club with the second biggest former players association in Britain. And you guys used to come to the games and meet every Saturday when we were at home. And they've taken that away from you. How do you feel about that?
Well, obviously, very disappointed. I mean, I came up from the fourth division, never mind the third, and went through going fourth, third, second, first.
We've got a clap at last.
But, I mean, to lose what we've made up to what we had is unbelievable, and I think it's just devastating that we don't go get back to the Ricoh. I mean, you know, what can I say? To my mind, we're playing as Northampton reserves when we play at Northampton.
Ranch. Straight away, finish, lads. Thank you. Now, if there's any trouble, I've brought the army with me. Yeah. No, not the sky blue army. Calm down, lads. They're aiming the tank at me. They think me act shit. Ron, shh. Right, just give us a second, lads, and we'll have a sing together. Ron. I said I was celebrating the 50th anniversary of the great Jimmy Hill side that you were part of. We've got eight or nine of those players, and I'm just telling you now, when we're back to Ricoh, we're going to have a day, and we're going to bring all of you lads back onto the pitch so these people can greet you and thank you for what you did for the club. So, how do you feel about that?
Well, yeah, it would be marvellous to get back to the Ricoh. I mean... I can't see any sense in building a new bloody stadium. Well, how sensible is that? All I want to do is see the lads back at the Ricoh. Although every year I get flu because I freeze me chopper off. And that is the truth. I know, I'm sorry about the families. But every year I get the same symptoms, so I don't go in the cold weather if I can help it. So they're going to get me a room inside, I think.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear from Ronnie Farmer. Our next guest, ladies and gentlemen. His next guest played in the 1987 Cup final. He's just going to say hello to you. Put your hands together for Micky Gynn. Jimmy, go on then. It's all right, lads, thanks. He knows who he is. Micky, again, thank you for supporting today. The trust with the former players who are supporting this march today. Take it, your feelings are same as ours. Let's get back to the Ricoh as soon as possible.
That's right. We all feel the same about this. It's a scandalous situation. The quicker it's sorted, the better. Obviously, I've done a bit of work at the ground at Sixfields for the PFA. And
calm down.
And I hated every minute of it. But, you know, it's something. Yeah, I understand the frustration of all the supporters because I'm obviously an ex-player and a supporter now, and we all want them back in Coventry. The quicker the Football League get the red sorted out, the better, and let's so all the pressure that everybody's putting on the Football League, things will change.
Ladies and gentlemen, Micky Gynn. Thanks, Micky. Thank you, Sean. Give him a round of applause. Last but not least, the president of the Coventry City Farmers Players Association, Kirk Stevens. All right, Kirk. I want everybody to give a round of applause. Kirk, 62 today. He's 2-10 next week. And now, hold on, I'm taking the piss. You weren't listening. I said he's 62 today. He's 2-10 next week. Kirk, it's fabulous to see you. I know you've travelled in from a great distance, Nuneaton. Yeah, come on, just because it's a shithole. Shh. Kirk, our thoughts on the former players. Last year we voted throughout the country, Scotland, Wales, Ireland and abroad, and the unanimous decision was none of the former players would go to Northampton, and we're not going to do the same again this year, are we?
Globally, I've got to say from the off, I mean, it's fantastic to see the support here again. I mean, the support's been there and it's going to be there forevermore for Coventry City Football Club. Like you guys, I'm from Coventry, born and bred here, and all I want to see is the Sky Blues playing at what is our home, in our hometown, which is at the Ricoh. A few years ago, we weren't robbed of our memories, but our memories were taken away from us from Ifield Road, and they built the Ricoh, and what a fantastic stadium it is, but we've got so many great memories at Ifield Road. So we're hoping to build some at the Ricoh. But unfortunately, for me, we're being stripped of all our credibility, and for me, to face people in the street, and they say, where are you from, who do you support, Coventry City? You know, we've got no, there's nothing there for me at the moment. Our credibility's been stripped by these people. I've got nothing but hatred is a big word, but I hate what they've done to us. I hate what they've done to you. I hate what they've done to the football club. I mean, I'm talking with a real passion here. I really, really don't want to anything to do with CCFC. If CCFC are not going to go out, then why not let us come back home? Let's give the football club back to the people of Coventry. And the sooner they do that, I think you proved it here today. I mean, I've just walked up the street and there's streams of people going. We've done this last year. We don't want to be doing this again next year. We want to be holding hands down at the Ricoh, cheering the team on there. How the team are managing this year, managed last year on the pitch, was an incredible achievement. It's very difficult for the players to be playing somewhere like that. So to the people that do go down to Northampton, I'm not looking back and saying, no, hang on, that's their belief, they want to do that. I will never, ever, ever set foot in Northampton football ground whilst we're going down there. But that's my choice. I know, I can hear the roars now, that's your choice as well. Listen, I don't know how this is going to be resolved. I've not heard nothing about the new stadium for many, many months now that's been promised. I've not heard nothing about us moving back into the Ricoh. They say they want to talk again. If they want to talk, brilliant, but let's do the walking now, not the talking, and get us back to the Ricoh. Great to see you all here. See you down the Ricoh soon, hopefully.
Kirk Stevens! Kirk. Ladies and gentlemen, I wore this shirt today for a very poignant reason. It's got the crest of Northern Ireland, the crest of the Republic of Ireland. I'll tell you why. Because those people sat down and talked and put things right. That's what these arseholes need to do. Thanks for listening. God bless all here. See you back in the Ricoh. Good night. God bless.
Thank you, Billy. Thank you, Kirk. Thank you, Micky. And thank you, Ron. The Sky Blue Legends.